everyone. It is good to see you again. Hope you all are fine. I, Saba Khan, is going to teach you maths for standard 7. So let's start with the first chapter, geometrical construction. So the first chapter of part 1, geometrical construction. The first part is given as a revision that you have learned in your previous class 6th standard. It was about line, line segment, angle, angle bisector, how to measure the angle, how to write the measurement of the angle, then the angle bisector. You have learned about the angle bisector, how the ray is dividing the angle into two equal measurements. Then you have learned about the perpendicular bisector of the line segment. So we will do a quick revision with the help of the figure. So let's start it. Revision with the help of the figure. The first figure, here it is given. You can see that the figure is having arrow on both the side. That means it can be extended from both the side. The figure can be named as line L or line MN. It can be named in both the ways, line L or line MN. The second figure, here you can see that the both the end point has the dot. That means it cannot be extended from both the side. Here you can name it as line segment AB or only seg AB. That is segment AB, you can write it as seg AB. The third figure, here you can see angle PQR. The measurement of the angle PQR is 40 degree. So the name of this figure, it can be written in two ways, angle PQR or angle Q. If we have to add the measurement, we have to write measurement, here M is measurement, angle PQR is equal to 40 degree. The fourth figure, here you can see that the angle is there, angle XYZ. But in between you can see a ray, that is one end is your dot, another end is your arrow. Ray YW is dividing the angle XYZ into two equal half. Two equal half means both the sign is same. So it can be written, this figure can be written as ray YW bisect. Bisect means into two equal half. If it is of 60 degree, then it will be XYW will be of 30 degree and YWYZ will be of 30 degree. So ray YW bisect the angle XYZ. Measurement of angle XYW is equal to measurement of angle WYZ. The last figure, here you can see that the segment AB is been divided by the line CD, and this signs indicate that it is a perpendicular, that is 90 degree. So it can be named as line CD is the perpendicular, that is 90 degree, bisector of segment AB. This sign says that it is divided into two equal half. So line CD, this is a sign of a perpendicular to the segment AB, and segment AM is equal to the segment MB. So the main part of the chapter that you are going to learn in this class is the first part is given, the property of the angle bisector of a triangle. So here it is given, angle bisector of a triangle. So here first you have to draw the triangle PQR. So this we will construct it and I will show you on the paper. So we are going to do the construction, the property of the angle bisector of a triangle. So first we have drawn here the triangle PQR. So we will divide the angle bisector of all the three angles of a triangle. So first I will try to draw the angle bisector of the angle Q. So this is the protractor, and here any measurement you have to take and you have to keep your seal point on Q because we are drawing the angle bisector of angle Q. So keep your seal point over here and take any measurement without disturbing the measurement. You will draw the arc on the opposite arms of the angle. Then you will take the measurement and keeping on the same measurement, you will take the arc outside the triangle. I got 1 point. Now I will draw the line, that is, I got this intersection of the two arc. Now from point angle Q, I will join this point. So I will name this A. So ray QA is a bisector of the angle PQR. Similarly, I will draw for the angle R. Here I will keep my steel point. I will take any measurement that will come inside the triangle and I will draw a arc. The same measurement will be on the other arms of the angle R. Then I will increase the measurement in such a way that when I will draw the arc, it will go outside the triangle from here and I got a point of intersection of the arc and I will join this with the angle R. Name as B. Then now I have to draw the angle bisector from the angle P. So I will keep the steel point. I will keep the steel point on P and I will draw the arc. I got a point of intersection of the arc. I will join it with the P. You can see that the angle bisector of all the three angles are coming and meeting at a common point, and this common point we have to name it as I. So the angle bisector so you can see that here the sign says that these two angles are congruent because this is the angle bisector. These two angles are congruent because it is the angle bisector and this also. So these are the sign shows that it is congruent, the angle bisector. I will give this name as C. So all the angle bisector of the triangle PQR are meeting at a same point I. So here the three angle bisector pass through the same point, that is, they are concurrent. So I can say that the angle bisector are concurrent because they are passing through the same point, concurrent points. So you have seen that the three bisector of the triangle PQR passes through the same point I. So this point I is known as the lines are concurrent lines, that the angle bisector of all the three angles are the passing through the same point I. So they are known as the concurrent line, and the point I is called the point of concurrence. Point I is known as the point of the concurrence. Now we will draw the perpendicular IX, IY and IZ on the side of the triangle, that is PQR, to the side PQ, QR and PR. We have to draw in such a way that to draw a perpendicular, when we are drawing the perpendicular of a point outside the line. So you have done in your previous class that there is a line L. The same way you have to draw in the triangle PQR also, that is a perpendicular of the point. Here the point P is there, but in your figure point I is outside the line. So how to draw? Here you will take the compass, you will keep the steel point of the compass on the point from which you have to draw the perpendicular, and we will draw an arc. That means the line through which you have to draw the perpendicular, you will draw an arc that is cutting into two points, point A and point B. Then I will keep the steel point on point A and I will draw the arc. The same measurement and I will get a point. Here I will draw a line and this is perpendicular. So I can say that PM is perpendicular to the line L, but P was outside the line. The same way you have to draw, that is from the point I, that is your point of concurrence, you have to draw the perpendicular there to the line PQ, because your I is outside the line PQ. So I have drawn this sign indicate that it is perpendicular. The same way you have to draw IY, that is a point I is outside the line segment QR, and you will get IY perpendicular to QR. The same way you have to draw IZ perpendicular to PR. So now when you will measure the length of IX and IY and IZ, you will get that all this perpendicular from the point of concurrence are equal. So we can say that the measurement of length IX and length IY is equal to length IZ. So the three perpendicular drawn from the point of concurrence are of equal measure. Second part that you are going to learn in this chapter is the property of perpendicular bisector of the side of a triangle. Previously it was angle bisector, now it is perpendicular bisector of the side. So here two figures are given. You can say that this figure is an acute angle triangle because all the angles are less than 90. This figure is an obtuse angle triangle. So we will do both the construction and we will see that the property of the perpendicular bisector of a triangle. Type 1 is acute angle triangle. We are going to learn the property of the perpendicular bisector of the side. Here it is related to the side. Previously it was related to the angle. So the first type is acute angle triangle. Here you can see that a triangle XYZ is an acute angle triangle. We have to draw the perpendicular of side XY, the perpendicular of YZ and the perpendicular of XZ. So we will take the compass. We will take the steel point because we have to draw the perpendicular of the first side of a triangle XY. So either you keep it on Y or you keep it on X. We will keep it on this Y and we will take orally, that is more than half of this measurement. You have to take more than half and I will cut the arc on both side of the segment of the triangle. So I have cut here the same measurement. I will take it from X also. I will not disturb it. And the same measurement. Here I am not getting the same. So I will cut the arc again. So I got two points and I will join this. I will join this. So this is your perpendicular. Here it is your perpendicular. Then I will make a perpendicular bisector. It is divided into two equal halves. If you want, you can take this as a point M. Then I will keep the steel point on Z. Here also I am making the perpendicular bisector of the segment YZ. So I will take more than half of YZ orally and I will cut an arc over here. And I will cut an arc over here. Both the side. Same measurement without disturbing the compass. I will cut arc over here. I will join this point. This is your perpendicular. This is your N. I am showing this that it is a bisector. Here it was by 1 mark, that is XM is equal to MY. Here YN, because here the sign is 2 arrows, here it is NZ, both are equal. Now I will draw the perpendicular bisector of the third side of a triangle. I will keep it at Z and I will take it as more than half. This is more than half. I will cut arc over here and I will cut arc over here. The same measurement. I will join the lines. This is perpendicular, this will be O. This is 1, 2, 3 and this is 1, 2, 3. Now this sign says that XZO is equal to OZ because it is perpendicular bisector. Now you can see that the perpendicular bisector of all the three sides of an acute angle triangle is meeting at a point. We will give this name. This point C is known as point of concurrent because all the three perpendicular bisector of the triangle XYZ is meeting as a single point, so it is known as the perpendicular bisector of all three side is known as point of concurrence. Now the second type that we are going to learn is obtuse angle triangle. Here you can see that the triangle XYZ is an obtuse angle triangle. So same procedure we will use to make the perpendicular bisector of this obtuse angle triangle. Here also I will make the first perpendicular, take more than half of the side XY and I will cut over here and I will cut over here. More than half orally, no need of taking the measurement. Then you will keep over here and you will cut arc over here and you will cut arc over here. You will join these two points. This is your perpendicular. You can give the name as M. XM is equal to MY. So I have drawn the perpendicular bisector of the side XY. So similarly, I will make the perpendicular bisector of the side YZ. That is more than half. I will cut an arc over here. I will cut an arc over here. I will join the points. Try to cut the first perpendicular line drawn by the previous segment. So this is your perpendicular, this is your N and YN is equal to NZ. Now I will draw the perpendicular bisector of the third side of the obtuse angle triangle. I am taking the more than half. I will take over here. I'm not getting the point, so I will extend the I got this point. This is your O. XO is equal to OZ. Now you can see that the point of concurrence C, where all the three perpendicular bisector are meeting, that C is outside the triangle. In obtuse angle triangle, you can find that the point of concurrent is outside the triangle, and in acute angle triangle you can see that the point of concurrent is inside the triangle. So when you will measure the length CX, it will be equal to the length CY is equal to the length CZ. Similarly, in acute angle triangle also, length CX is equal to length CY is equal to the length CZ. Point C of the concurrence is called circumcenter. By the perpendicular bisector of all three sides of a triangle, that is perpendicular bisector of all three sides of a triangle, this is known as the circumcenter. So here the point C is known as the circumcenter. Here also, that is type 1 acute angle triangle, you are getting the C inside the triangle, that is acute angle triangle. So this point C is known as your circumcenter. This is also known as a circumcenter. But previously what we have done, that is the property of the angle bisector, we are getting the point of concurrence, the I is the point of concurrence by from the bisector of the angle bisector of the triangle. So the point of concurrence is called in center. By the angle bisector of the triangle, we are getting your in center, and by the perpendicular bisector of the side of a triangle, we are getting the circumcenter. In your textbook also, here a summary is given: the angle bisector of a triangle are concurrent, their point of concurrence is at the in center, that is we are getting from the angle bisector. But the perpendicular bisector of the side of a triangle are concurrent, both are concurrent, but their point of concurrence is called as the circumcenter. Here it is known as the in center because it is by the angle bisector. Here we are getting it from the perpendicular bisector of the side of the triangle, then it is known as the circumcenter. Hope you all have understand. This was a explanation before the exercise. So this is all for this session. In the next session, we will do the exercise based on all this explanation. Thank you.